In this video, we're going to be in Zoho Analytics, which is a SQL-based database where you can bring in the various modules from anything from books, CRM, any module you want. You basically would be setting up the data sources, what to bring in, how often they need to refresh, things like that. We're going to take a quick look at making a simple SQL query, which helps basically take information from one or more tables and combining them based on certain criteria. So we're just going to do a simple one to show you. First, we're going to start by creating, and we want to create a query table, and it's going to come and gives you an automatic, just kind of a basic select statement. And we are going to change this to make it look one like typical. If you have worked with SQL statements before, you will be familiar kind of with the syntax and just on how things look. This is just more preference. Doesn't have to be this way. But this is just a personal way that I like to do it because this is how I was taught. And so it just makes it look cleaner and nicer. As you go through, it gives you suggestions. Okay. So you can look to see, and we were going to go with the meetings. And so what these are the columns that you want to grab. And so we're going to delete that, and we will start with the title. And for each one, you want a comma after that shows that it's looking for more. To end it, you'll notice the last field will not have the comma after it. Let's go with, let's see, the title, the event type, hours to bill, what it was related to. Oops. Let's do host name. And down here, the from is the actual table. And so if you click on that, it enters that in. And then we're going to put a where clause. And this is basically giving you your conditional. And we're going to say the host name equals me. And then you can come down here. And this would show you, then it gives you a preview of the results. Okay, if we want to add some more fields, let's say. So let's go. We want estimated meeting revenue. Then you would come up here. You'd give it a name. And let's just say we want to save it. And now if we go into view mode, you would see all the meetings that I have taken. Now, what we can also do is take it a little further, and the related to, all we're seeing is the ID number. And I know that typically that is a contact. Actually, if we go back in here, and we look, so we're going to go to, I'm going to grab open the contacts so you can kind of see. Okay. And so we have the ID. I want to be able to just grab the first and last name based on their ID. And so I can create another query where I just want to grab from the contacts, I want to be able to grab their name. Last name and first name. And we're going from the contacts. Let's also grab the ID. And if we execute that, we're going to see their ID with the name. We'll go ahead and save it. Okay, so now what I can do is we are going to do what's called a left join, which means we're taking everything from this left table, which the first table is the left table. That would be the meetings. And we're going to go down. Oh, before I do this, we're going to save. We're going to refresh because since we added this new table here for that to be able to show up over here, we want to change related to we're going to take out we're going to do the left join of we're going to put the query name table ID equals related to. And you can check your query. One of the things that you can do too, this is joining those tables. If I wanted to go, I could break it down even more so to be able to, if I wanted just to go for my name, I could take it back and create basically another query where I would then join those two basically on those. So this is just kind of giving you some feel for it. But a suggestion would be go check out w3schools.com. They have a lot of great helpful tips for various SQL and all kinds of others, but a great one. But these are just things that can be used. And then once you have this information, you can go in and build reports based off of what's found from those. And so it's fairly easy. You can get really complex and put more and more on here of select statements and multiple joins. And so, but this is just a basic, simple one. Like I said, very easy to put together. You can see your results. And there you have it. That's just a little bit of what analytics can do and a little bit of SQL in there for you. If you need any help with any of your Zoho products, zcrmhelp.com is our website. Thank you and have a great one.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.